Reminds me of a dressing room I once used. So it's from school, shipyards, and after the shipyards I came here. The Live Theatre Company, my favourite theatre in Newcastle. And it was here I did my first professional acting job in a play called The Long Line by Tom Hadaway. I played a character called George Pearson. There was about 150 people in the audience. And that night was the first night and was a critics' night, and they used to put all the crits in here. And the top of the crit in the Evening Chronicle in 1986 read, "It's green for go in this winter." Because green's my surname and go, so that convinced me I should be an actor. And this is where the audience came in. The lovely thing about that theatre company was you could sit down and have a meal, a pint of beer or anything. And if you didn't like the actor that was on stage, you threw your meal at them. Made that bit up. Just fill in time. And over here's a minibus. I used to drive the actors to all the venues, places like Kendal, Rhyl, Skegness. Get back here, I'm much more interesting. The yellow bus. Skegness, Rhyl, Bognor, Doncaster, Buttle Arts Centre and Wall's End. Well, that place there's a reason why I'm doing what I'm doing. Doing plays, great writers like Alan Plater, Tom Hadaway, who else? Working with actors like Tim Healy, Alan Armstrong, all from the Northeast. All great ambassadors for the Northeast. And this used to be the pub where we were, the Baltic Vaults pub where we used to go to before and after a show. All the actors used to sit in here, slumped. Of course, talking about the play, of course. And how many pints you could drink. I'm getting into this now, I'm cracking a joint. It's like Annika Reiser's nut. Anyway, around here is my favorite view in the world. Have a look at this. Have a look. Fantastic view. I used to come here just to find a bit of peace and contentment because basically I was terrified. Pooping me pants before a show. So I used to come down here. Acting in front of me mum, actually, is the worst part of this whole thing because I feel as though I have to prove something to this person who's gone without for me. I feel as though I have to prove something to her, and of course I don't because she loves me, you know, as do all my family. But it's not about wanting to do acting, it's about needing to do it and dreaming about it. Dream about all this, being on Top of the Pops. I remember watching Sweet, the glam rock age, all that stuff, all these great bands, Gary Glitter. There I was, me and Romy number one, give me the mic. Oh, my love. I was in my element. I really was. I really enjoyed Top of the Pops. It was great. And being on a film set here, doing interviews, this whole thing. And looking out, when out from the working class community of Dudley, looking at that profession, it was very aloof. It was, you couldn't touch the acting profession, couldn't touch this film profession, because it was that Hollywood thing. You couldn't get near it. But I always wanted to, and I got in. So I got in.
But now he's a natural. I mean, he doesn't need any training. It just comes very naturally to him. And to be honest, you don't learn a lot at drama school except, well, I didn't, except how to get on with other actors and perform plays, which Rob did as much of as me at the live theatre, and that's where he learned his trade. So he hasn't got, I don't think he's got that much to learn on the, well, not on the acting front.
I'm not answering any more questions. I've had enough. Cut to a song. Cut to one of the songs we did. We did some great songs. Here's one coming up. That was a good link, wasn't it? I thought it was quite cool.
Ever since You feel.